Hi. Plastic bags are devastating for the ecosystem. They make a mess in a grocery cart, and most of all, they don't keep anything cold. Grocery shopping has become a 21st century chaos, so we created Tessellation & Co. Bags.
Through the ideation of our product, we grappled with separating weights and organic bug spray. But the abundance of wasted plastic bags and long trips to the grocery store persisted, so Alyssa brought up the idea of a set of reusable bags. To reach what we're going to show you today, we went through a bunch of different prototypes. We started with this from IKEA, and we placed Velcro on the sides to give everyone a sense of what we were hoping to achieve. Then we ordered a bunch of free samples. We started with these from Discount Mugs. We placed a slit in the side between the exterior of the bag and the insulation, but unfortunately these melted under the heat of a hot glue gun. Finally, we received these heat point insulated bags from bag makers, and we absolutely love them. Fast forward a few months, we now have a dual set that will be brought to market soon and retails for $15.99.
What are they? It's a set of two bags. It can be a grocery cart organized with a divided reusable bag, or a cooler that keeps food cold for up to 8 hours and reduces shopping time by 15%. Connected by Velcro, it allows you to keep your groceries organized and avoid a mess from shopping. While continuing with eco-friendly trends, I designed a quote art bag that will be attractive to customers.
Now that you know a little bit about our product, just who are we? Hello, I'm Jennifer, the COO.
I'm Jack, I'm the CFO.
I'm Serena, the CMO.
I'm Alyssa, the CEO.
And I'm Jesse, the CEO. And we're Tessellation & Co., revolutionizing the grocery shopping experience.
So who's going to buy our product? The mom of the preschooler is always running low on time. An eco-friendly consumer and the family would rather not spend 10 cents on plastic bag taxes. In terms of our TAM and SAM, we used data from the U.S. Census Bureau and narrowed it down from the U.S. population to women to middle-aged women. Considering our dual set costs $15.99, we've got a TAM of $1.4 billion. For SAM, we focused on the northwest suburbs of Chicago, giving us 105,000 customers and giving us a SAM of $1.7 million. We have 3,790 early adopters, giving us a 0.3% of market share. Although that number is small, we do hit all of our early adopters, and we also reach a wider audience through our market strategies. For our channels, we are going to use our website and Etsy and face-to-face interactions to sell our product to our customers. Our Etsy is going to be linked to our website for our non-local consumers, and for face-to-face interactions, we're going to use that for our local consumers.
But aren't reusable bags already in use? They're durable and foldable. They're sold at Jewel, Trader Joe's, even in bulk at Costco. But most of them aren't insulated, and when you put them in your cart, they collapse. Then there's grab bags, our most formidable competition. But they were an as seen on TV fad that went out of business just recently. Finally, there's trunk organizers. But for the millennial or mom at the grocery store, I can't see them using a trunk organizer or even taking it to a soccer game. Our competition solved the problem of plastic bags. They got society ready for a solution. But we've solved the problem of lifestyle organization. Our product is light, portable, and uses Velcro connected bags that can be transferred from your grocery cart directly into your trunk, all while socially eliminating the million plastic bags used around the world every minute.
So what makes us different? One of the main modifications we made to our bag was adding a snap bottom. Essentially, it's a piece of pliable material that's inserted into the base of the bag so that when the customer opens the bag, it snaps into place, allowing the bag to stay upright and sturdy even when there's nothing inside of it. Even with that massive modification, our bags are still completely portable, foldable, and light, allowing for easy transport. In terms of insulation, we are heat point insulated bags, meaning that our bags keep items cold for up to 8 hours as opposed to your typical. In addition, our bags are extremely versatile in two major ways. One being that there's Velcro on the sides of our bags, which allow the bag sets to be organized any way the consumer wants them to, as well as consumers being allowed to just take one bag if it fits their needs best. In addition, like we've mentioned, we are not just for grocery shopping. We are a lifestyle organizer. And what that means is that our bags also double as a portable cooler. So instead of going to your kid's soccer game or the beach and lugging around a massive rolling cooler, you can throw a couple items into our bag, throw it over your shoulder, and you're good to go because of our long-standing insulation power. And most importantly, our bags are eco-friendly. They eliminate the need for plastic bags, which is a huge part of our company promise and Go Green initiative.
Our bags are made up of five components. We have our bags, which as we said before, is a dual set, so it's gonna be two in each set. Silicone, Velcro, and our packaging. Our packaging is made up of cardstock, the ink to put on the cardstock, as well as a piece of fabric around it. It's divvied up right now as like this, and then we have $9.50 for our COGS at the moment. Our key partner right now is Bagmakers, who right now is supplying our bags and is our main distributor. Right now for year one, we're looking at $1,600 in our first year for revenue. We hope to grow to about $2,200 by year five. Our SG&A right now is our font license, the domain name, and for year one, we also have some legal fees. And after year one, that goes away, so that's why you see this big jump in that income from year one, year two.
So up right now, you just see some basic price points we're looking at for bags. Like Jack mentioned, bags are the biggest component of our pod, so that's really a big thing we've been working on this year. In full disclosure, we have not manufactured bag sets yet, but this is because, as a group, we collectively decided it would be a smarter financial decision to wait to purchase bags in bulk at $3.45 per bag, as opposed to rushing into it and buying $6 bags right now. Buying bags at $3.45 means that we are buying from a distributor, and it leaves us with a 40.6% profit margin. As a group, we really wanted to increase that profit margin over the course of the year, so we've looked at multiple ways to do that, and right now we're zeroing in on becoming the distributor ourselves. So in order to do that, we have to do two things. One being we have to transition into an LLC and get a state distribution license, and then we also have to purchase a basic ASI number, which will cost us about $150 a month. After doing those two things, we ourselves can buy directly from bag makers, eliminating the middlemen, and purchase bags for $3 each, which gives us a profit margin of 46.8%. We have also looked into overseas manufacturing, where we're in talks with someone from Shanghai for a portion of the year, and we found that we can purchase bags at $2 each if we were to go overseas, and that gives us a profit margin of 59%. But because of the size and scale of our startup and the fact that we are high school entrepreneurship students, we decided to stay domestic and local for right now. But that transition to an LLC is a jump that we are looking to make in the near future to increase our profit margin. And because of this long-term financial plan and continued profitability and versatility in our financial plan, we believe that we are a valuable economic asset to investors.
Social media is our main platform to connect with our consumers. As the CMO, I regularly update on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter on the happenings of Tessellation & Co. Also, I use YouTube as a platform to send our products to mommy bloggers in order for us to create traction and streamline sales to other locations.
As you can see, here is our website. On our homepage, we have a short video that will just show our customers how to simply use our product. Then we have a short About Us tab, which gives a personal touch to our customers with a short bio about us. And we have our products tab here. We just have pictures of bags, but in the near future, we will have the links to actually purchase the bags, as long as we have all of our social media currently linked. We also have a survey so that all of our customers can find their exact need for the bags and what they could use them for. Next, our BMC has shifted tremendously since September. We started off focusing on the grocery market, and then we started working with our mentor, Craig. Craig helped us broaden our market from just the grocery market to outdoor events and portable coolers. Through our MVP implementation, we started off as a 4-bag set and then shifted to a 2-bag set, reducing our time to 20 minutes per set. Here we would be able to have our bags cost $3.49, and we don't have labor costs factored in right now.
In terms of our group commitment to investors, we are a group of young, motivated, resilient entrepreneurs that believe we have found a gaping hole in a market that needs a solution. Our company is valuable to you because of our massive, positive environmental impact just waiting to happen, as well as the fact that our bags are a culmination of all the positives consumers look for in a reusable bag, just in one place, so therefore they come to us. In the end, we are looking for $1,000 in funding in order to finance a bulk order of bags, which will cost us roughly $650, as well as to purchase the material we use to modify the bags, which includes silicone, Velcro, and fabric, and as well to work on our packaging. Our packaging right now is just pretty basic. It's just a piece of cardstock with some information on it, as well as a strip of grass grain fabric with Velcro, and we hope that customers will keep that strip of fabric and the Velcro to use as a way to keep their bag set organized in the future. We currently have 30 pre-orders that are just waiting to be fulfilled, and with your help and advice, we hope that we can get to those very soon.
Well, not an LLC currently, we hope to be one in the future. All of us plan on continuing with Teen Tessellation next year and pursuing a business degree, with most of us planning on double majoring in other realms such as economics, engineering, and even graphic design. To you as investors, with our high profit margins and intrinsic motivation, this is a lucrative opportunity to create high returns for both you and the environment. Plastic bags are a huge environmental problem. They don't biodegrade, they stay around forever, and even when we think they're out of the ecosystem, they can still be digested by animals. There isn't a solution on the market, but now you can make a change. Tessellation & Co. bags will revolutionize your lifestyle. They will fight and enlighten consumers to the war on plastic. They will change the face of plastic in the marketplace.
Join the revolution. Thank you. I got a couple of questions. One would be about, as you scale up and so forth, so right now you're looking at your marketing streams are Etsy, Instagram, Twitter, and things like that. As you guys start moving down, what other, have you guys done any brainstorming as far as where else you're going to go or how else you're going to try to get your report out? Because as you know, and you can see from other companies, the biggest challenge that they have is really changing the culture, right? Because people are used to just going to the store and grab a bag. So what have you guys thought, or have you spent any time trying to figure out how you're going to try to change? Because it's really a cultural shift that is what you're trying to develop. I think it's great. You guys have done a great job. So how have you thought about that, or have you given any thoughts on that?
So I think what we're planning on doing with that is we're planning on tackling different areas at first. So we're going to start in the areas that have bag taxes. So like Chicago right now, because they just implemented it, that's where we're going to start. And I think we're going to go like neighborhoods from there. I know we had talked about getting on like the Nextdoor website. So like what we can get into a neighborhood, we can like create traction in the grocery stores in that neighborhood. And so just tackling the different areas and neighborhoods at different times.
Also like setting up booths to like different games, like soccer games and stuff, and just kind of like having like trade shows or anything, or just like showing our product to like different consumers when they come in with like families and stuff, because that's one of our biggest, customer segments.
Also, in a broader sense, we also have two main ideas. Obviously, we are going to, at some point, introduce Google Ads or pay-per-click ads on Facebook specifically because the mom demographic is there. So that's something we are planning to implement in the future. And we did touch on the mommy bloggers aspect. One way that we're trying to reach a broad audience, especially in our area, is there's women who have young children that will vlog, so basically videotape their lives and put it online. And we're looking to potentially maybe partner with them and send them a bag set and have them try it out and just videotape their experience at the grocery store, because that's a customer base of 100,000 people that you've just reached for sending someone one bag set or just giving them a piece of your profit. So we are trying to be creative with our marketing and hit that demographic so that it just kind of propagates, because social media is its own world, and if you get out there, people will share it.
No, I'm just going to reinforce what you just said. I'm a friend that works for Bravo Lab, and the vloggers and the bloggers are more influential than the retail, and they're kind of freaking out at Revlon because they don't know what to do about it. So you're right on the cusp of that. I had no idea, so it's really impressive.
Outstanding. You have a very, very good understanding of your product and actually the finances behind it as well. The gross profit, everything else, very impressive.
Thank you.
What's been your biggest challenge so far out of this whole process from day one until today? What's the biggest obstacle that you've had to get across so far?
I think finding the bags.
Yes.
we've spent like a lot of days in class like debating, do we want to purchase them at like $4 or $5 for a bag so we can have them, we can start cranking out those pre-orders, or do we want to wait until we have more capital so we can finance them at the lower per unit price? So like just deciding when we want to purchase the bags.
And in addition to that, it's been, we found the style bag we want, which are the heat press, and there's many companies that will sell them to us, some for $7, some for $3.49, and it's getting them without the middleman at that cheapest price. And we found, with Craig's help, he had a friend who has the number to get a hold of bag makers, and so being able to get them at that lowest price needs a bunch of legal terms that we have to have, like titles. So achieving those just to get the bags have been a huge challenge.
I think you guys can embrace them. 5 minutes
of school. Yes. Thank you.
That's great.
Really good.
Okay. Great.